be considering only the first degree equations. Let's consider a small example where XYZ company is operating since 2002 in manufacturing of a product. Company has 6 zonal offices and 45 branches all over India. Now with this data only, you are supposed to predict and forecast the sales of one of their product in 2022. Here's the reflection point. Pause the video and think. Expecting the same trend to continue with this data, can you predict the sales in 2022? Think for a while and give your response. Once this is over, you may release the pause. It is very difficult with this particular data to predict anything in a future. We require some precise data in the past to predict something in a future, and therefore another additional data is given to you. Look at the table below. Here the sales figure in lakhs from 2014, 2015, 2016, 2017 and 2018. So for the last 5 years, the sales figures are given. Now looking at this sales figure, can you predict? Can you predict the sales in 2022? We take another reflection point. Pause the video and think. Expecting the same trend to continue, now with the data of sales, can you predict sales in 2022? Definitely, it will be more closer and you can go for better assessment. Think for a while and give your response. Once response is over, you may release the pause. Now everybody's prediction may be different and company may or may not accept the. Let us learn the scientific method for fitting the baseline. If data is given in the form of X and Y coordinates and we can plot them, and as per the scatter diagram, we can see the data is spread all over the graph. Now with this distributed data, can we predict the future expected value more precisely? Hence we try to fit a straight line in the given data. Now straight line with any slope may not work. Therefore, we would like to understand the principle of fitting the line and why we should call it as a best fit line. Let's see the underlying scientific principle for fitting the best line. Here the data is connected with segments. Again, it's not continuous line. The data is only connected. We'll see the concept of best fit line. When best fit line, it may go through all the points or one of the point or 2 points, or it may not go through any point. However, with the central tendency, it best fit in the entire data. What is the principle? Principle is, the value given by the trend line and the actual value, the difference in that will be called as error. Now, if we sum the error, as it is a best fit line, probably the error on one side may cancel the error on other side. So in order that the error should not be cancelled, but they should reflect their effect, we make square of them. By making square, the sign wise, all the errors will become positive. At the same time, the errors are exaggerated. Then summation of all these exaggerated errors is minimum for the best fit line, is the underlying principle. Basic method of least square It is basically the square of the deviation of trained value from actual value, summation of all these squares of the error is minimum, that is least, thus the name least square, and we get a best fit line. Now let us try to apply this least square method on the earlier given problem. The methodology is very simple. We'll fit a straight line having equation y is equal to a plus bx. As it was already discussed, that line may contain one point, two point, or all points, or may not contain any points, but it shows central tendency. So instead of taking x and y coordinate of one point or two point, we take all points x coordinate, all points y coordinate together, and hence we would like to operate everything on summed data. So we take summation y is equal to summation a, which is na, plus summation bx, which is b summation x. And as we need two equations, because we have two unknowns a and b, we multiply the entire equation by x. Y is equal to a plus bx. When we multiply by x, it becomes xy is equal to ax plus bx square, and we take summation. Summation xy is equal to a summation x plus b summation x square, and now we find values for all these with respect to the given data. Data is given tabulated below, and we have taken 2016 as a base year, and x equal to 0 for that. Corresponding values for summation x, summation xy, summation y are obtained. Using these values, we will try to form two equations. We got two equations. By solving them, we get both unknown, and we get the final equation of line y is equal to 255 plus 27.5 x. For cells in 2022, we put value of x as 6, and we get the value of cells as 420 lakhs. Thus, we can predict cells in future by best fit trend. तिकट करा लगे तुम्हारे शेवट से Now we have plotted the actual data are shown on the graph in a scatter diagram, and five dots are shown pertaining to the years 2014 to 2018, and a line with the equation y is equal to a plus by, which we have obtained. We have drawn the line and we have extrapolated the result for 2022. Thus, with the least square and best fit line, we can predict the future forecast. And this predicted by anybody will be the same and having scientific base. In order to master this particular thing, we have proposed one quiz on another numerical giving different values of x and y, and you are requested to go for a prediction of future value. And we have based another quiz wherein you will find the difference between trained value and the actual value for the given data. You are supposed to solve both the things on the basis of theory which you have learned. This technique of best fit line or the least square method can be used to forecast anything in future based on things available in the past. It could be forecasting about the population of a village. It could be forecasting about the literacy percentage. It could be forecasting about the income levels of people and many more. For any forecasting, we can use the current method and is having very many applications in business and industry. Thank you all, and try to practice it to master it. Thank you once again.